There are no corporations around that I know today that are 600 years old. So if you buy it at the very beginning and you keep it to the very end, you just like a human life, you travel from zero to zero. And so if you haven't gotten anything in the interval, what has the journey been all about?
Well, what about this, the other theory that says, you're right about the 600 years, but they generally do live a fairly, they're like turtles, these some of these companies, and the capital gain can be quite interesting.
Oh, if you sell.
But the day you sell,
it,
yeah.
But if you keep it till the very end when it goes bankrupt.
So you like some income along. You like some income along the way.
Well, I think that the income is, if I put money out, I like to get some income back. If I never get anything back, what is it really worth?
Well, you're waiting for the capital gain, and that's not enough.
Maybe. Yeah.
And now you also say the ones that pay dividends are generally the ones that are thriving.
Well, the ones that can afford to pay dividends and at the same time thrive, yes. But I mean, if you pay out all the money in dividends, like in what these income trusts were all about, mm-hmm. Well, then you end up not being able to compete. You have to have enough of a return that you can pay dividends and grow, and you have to have good enough management and a strong enough position in the marketplace to do that, rather than only pay dividends or only to grow.
And so, why don't you like mutual funds?
I don't like mutual funds because the cost is too high. I think that's the main reason I don't like mutual funds. I also don't like mutual funds because usually the money flows in when the markets are high, and usually the money flows out when the markets are low. Because, as I said before, human beings act on emotions. When everybody has made money in the stock market, everybody who hasn't been in wants to get in. When everybody is losing money on the stock market, nobody wants to be identified with it.
But it's a commissions game, and that's what you don't like. For instance, you mentioned your firm does manage people's money, and it does put that money into diverse stocks. But for a tiny percentage, it's really that. It's the what you don't like is the mutual fund takes no risk, makes money in and out too.
Well, let's say that you get a 12% return on a stock, and you pay out 2.5% of that. And let's say the 12% gets taxed, so you're left with 6. You take 2.5% out of that, you're left with 3.5. Mm. The inflation is 3. You made a 0.5%.
And you say there's a lot of debt. You like to point out sort of the shell games that are played, whether it's by mutual funds or others. And you say there's a lot of debt in the economy right now, and we're going to inflate it away because it looks painless. So you're expecting a return of inflation.
Well, there has always been inflation in all over past history, going back as far as the earliest texts of the Babylonians and the Sumerians and the Egyptians.
To print money.
When the debts get too high, you print money, and that has always been the rule. And moreover, a little bit of inflation makes people invest because they don't want to lose the money and get no return. And a great deal of inflation, oddly enough, initially makes stocks and bonds go down. Now bonds go mm-hmm. down because they're indefinitely hurt by this inflation, but stocks, that's just exactly the time to buy them.
Or even to borrow.
Because they will overcome the inflation, especially if they have debts on the book, on the balance sheet, because those debts will be devalued and in effect, that will go into the equity aspect of it.
So we are kidding ourselves when we think that for the past decade or so, we've been living in an era of real money, solid money, low inflation.
That's correct.
It's about to fritter away.
It will fritter away because we have overspent on all kinds of, especially in consumer loans, especially in mortgages, and the people will not be able to pay those monies back. And many of the governments have done the same.
And is inflation better than a quote-unquote depression or
well,
a deflation?
Well, both are bad, but the inflation is somewhat better because at least people are investing and creating jobs because they're not going to survive having cash.